Have you? Good morning and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We also welcome our supporting backer families to the 2024 Budget Motels Australian National Championships being held here at the Harmonia German Club in Canberra. We would now like to ask our teams to start to enter the arena, and please give a warm welcome. First up, we have the teams representing Western Australia. And now we have the teams representing State of Australia. Let's put our hands together for our next teams representing the state, New South Wales. Yeah.
And now let's give a warm welcome to the state teams representing Queensland.
Thank you.
Okay, now everybody's in the room. One big round of applause, please, for all the states. Good morning. A warm welcome to all our teams from around Australia, and thank you for your support and efforts you have made to attend our championships. I'd first like to ask Josh Mooker to please come up and give an acknowledgement to country on behalf of APA, please. Singing the Australian National Anthem for us today. Please give a warm welcome to the Australian Harmony Choir. Please say a few words.
Martin. Look, I'm just going to make this quite short, but I just want to say on behalf of the staff and the board of directors and the management team of the Harmony Club, I'd like to welcome you all this week for this Bapa National. So we have a rich history in Q Sports over the last sort of 8 years, and this is just another example of you know, the place being utilised and Q Sports being utilised here, and we enjoy this. It's a very versatile place, very versatile room that we're in. We have choir practice, we have Mexican wrestling, we have Muay Thai, we have bands, we've even had ACDC who played in this room in 1972. So it's got quite a rich history, and we do all sorts of things, and we do it all really well. Hospitality is what we do, so if there's anything that we can do for you that's not right, not quite right, just let us know, that one of the staff know, will help you out and get you through the week. But welcome, hope you play the game in the right spirit, and have a really good time. And I would just like to mention, if you get a bit of time later on in the week, and you're not playing deep into the tournament, unfortunately, go and visit Canberra. It's got some fantastic attractions, and there's some great things to do in Canberra, so have a look around, enjoy your time in Canberra, and thanks for coming.
Thank you, Paul. So we made it. Here we are at the 2024 Budget Motels Australian National Championships. What a whirlwind 18 months since we initially set up BAPA. I would like to say a massive thank you to Budget Motels Group for coming on board and becoming BAPA's major sponsor for the 24 National Championships. Their support is so valuable to BAPA, and we have created a fantastic working relationship with them. Budget first came involved with BAPA for the IPA World League in 2023, and I'm very pleased to have them part of the 24 National Championships, so thank you again. Budget have also sponsored our LDPD players for the 2024 Blackball International World Championships and purchased all official shirts for the LDPD players who compete in Bridlington in October 24. So please can we give a huge round of applause to Budget Motels and their support to our organisation and players. So, you've all kept BAPA very busy. Time has flown by in the last year, and since our nationals back in March in Geelong, where the first year of BAPA and the IPA World League all done and dusted and finished, the 24 IPA has already started. To that, a fantastic week away in Johannesburg, South Africa, where many of you enjoyed a great complex which was out of this world, and who managed to sightsee, I think you will certainly say, South Africa is the most wonderful place, and what a fantastic Baldy Cup we all had. Blackball South Africa did an amazing job, and I'm certain one day soon we'll be back there for other events. In such a short space of time, and this week, we've hit a new milestone for Blackball and BAPA here in Australia by holding the biggest national Blackball Nationals ever held in Australia. I held the first one back in Adelaide in 2017, and some of you were there then, and in the area then, and also here again today. But our 24 nationals have reached just such under 250 players this week, all fighting to become the official Australian Blackball National Championships in teams, singles and pairs. All this would not be possible without you, the players, and it shows that BAPA is doing a great job, as we have nearly doubled our numbers of players attending from the 23 Nationals, and in the IPA we have doubled player numbers to 24 compared to the inaugural year of 2023. I would just briefly like to touch on the 25 National Championships, which will be held in Rockhampton, Queensland during March 25. We already have teams asking to enter the Nationals for them, and I'm pleased to say that entries will now be taken, so get your team sorted out and get entered. For the 25 National Championships, we are changing how the National Championship structure is run out. We have always asked by the players, can we play more than one event? The answer has always been no. Well, I'm pleased to say from 2025, the answer will no longer be no. We will be breaking up the singles and pairs from the team events and running them in blocks altogether, so that players, if age and gender allows, you can play in more than one singles and pairs event. From 2025, we will also introduce a brand new category, which will be the Grandmasters for players 16 and over. And as I was last night, when is the over 70s coming? In time to come, it is also hoped we will introduce ladies over 50 categories as well. This will happen once we have enough ladies teams that will not diminish the ladies category. Blackball wants to give its best to the players, as much pool as they can handle, plus deliver the best events we can. After all, you're playing for an Australian title sanctioned by Blackball International, the official world governing body, and the WPA. More information on these changes will be released in a press statement, which will be going out later today on our social media platforms and website. If any players wish to discuss these changes more and have any questions, we are here all week and happy to take any answers that you may have. So now on to our referees. During the year, we've been running referees courses, and I would like to ask our head referee, Chase Daly, to award our newly qualified referees their certificates and new shirts.
Thank you, Mark. I'd just like to welcome you all here, and what I'm going to do today is actually get our current referees to the front stage so that everyone can put a face to our referees. They're going to be in their state shirts, or they're going to be in a referee shirt. Just at least people can acknowledge those current referees before we bring up the newly qualified referees. So if I can get Matt Pearson, Hal Pritchard, Aki Ewan, Catherine Lindridge, Sharon Miskalkin, Matt Connor. This year we've also had six referees qualified, three are not with us today. The three new ones that will be here and joining us on the floor today, Tim Riley, Kelly Odo, Peyton Roberts, The other three referees that we have is Timothy Olsen. Timothy Olsen. Ben Moore. And Chris Jeffries. Will be assisting us throughout the duration of the tournament. If you see them in a white shirt, do get them over to the caller shop if you are unsure. Here is your block warning. Please ensure that you are all listening. There will be no discrimination by race, gender, appearance. If this happens, there is a code of conduct that all players must sign. Please read it very carefully. If we see it, there will be penalties. No food or drinks over the table. There is no drinking in the playing arena. If we see this, once again, you will be penalised. If you feel that someone's taking too long on the shot, get a referee over and we will start timing those frames. It will happen throughout the frame, so do get a referee to come and time it. We're going to try and have about two referees roaming the floor, plus myself here all day. So there's going to be someone around. The other thing I'm going to touch base with right now, it is in your team's packs, is the pairs. Now this is one that's going to cause a little bit of, maybe a little bit of hassle throughout the pairs when it happens. Here it is. When you break and the table is open, you may talk to your partner. Once you approach the table and take that shot, there is no talking with your partner thereafter. As soon as the visit finishes, the incoming team may talk to their partner until they take that shot. Now that remains for the duration of the visit. If the player is at the table and they haven't taken the shot and it's the very first shot of the visit, and they get up on their own accord, they may retreat back to their partner and talk. All right. Both players must stand at a neutral area and not roam the table to potentially guide the player where to shoot. You must retreat to a neutral area. Your team's captains yesterday received your team's packs. If your captain or if any of your players are unsure, do come up and see me before pair starts in the next couple of days. Thank you everyone and have a good week.
Thank you, Chase, and thank you, the referees, for taking time out during the week as well to help take part and help the players out. I would just like to give a final acknowledgement to three people that have been such help to BAPA in the last year in helping us take events forward in different ways. First, Dan Lynch from CueballTV. Dan got on board. Dan got on board with BAPA back in Geelong last year for the Nationals. We spoke about taking the streaming to different levels to enhance the streaming viewing, and we have continued to do that throughout the year with the IPA and with the Nationals. We still look at different ways now that we can still improve more. Dan, I thank you for all the work you have put into our events, and I want you to know how much it's appreciated. Secondly, Hal Pritchard. All his work goes unnoticed. He didn't want to take a position on the BAPA committee, but he's come on board. He's set up extra streaming from the outside of Dan, so we can manage to stream an extra three tables, and he also does streaming with the IPA. Hal has also set up the website for us and does lots of other technical work for us. So thank you very much, Hal, for all your amazing work. And finally, to John Coomer, our main photographer. John became involved with BAPA last year for the IPA, and players took to him straight away. Those that are here today that play in the IPA know full well what a down-to-earth guy John is and how much he'll go out of his way to make sure he catches that magic moment for you. Please don't be shy of John during the week. He will be round the venue taking photos, doing your team photos shortly. So if you want him to catch any moments for you with friends or whatever that you make, please make sure you get John to do that. So thank you very much, John, for being here this week and all your hard work. So now it's time, I think, we get these championships underway. I'd like to wish all players the best of luck this week, and come next Saturday, we will see new teams, singles and pairs players crowned Australian Blackball Champions for 2024. Can I now ask Paul to please do the traditional breaking of the balls on table two here, and I confirm the tournament open. Okay, finally, good luck everyone, enjoy the week and play well. If the teams for the 10 o'clock sessions can get themselves sorted, if there's any court-stack issues that you know of, please come and see us. The session will get underway at 10 o'clock. You can make your way to your tables that you're playing on and start practice if you wish.